I'm Daphne Richards. Our question this week is from viewer Christine Sills, who has a rotting prairie verbena. Christine says that she added about 4 inches of topsoil to her mostly clay soil. The plants grew all spring and summer and were covered in blooms in April and May. Then Christine says in the span of 1 week, the plants suddenly and quickly turned brown and then gray, dying from the center outward. All of the blooms shriveled and quickly fell off. Christine also notes that the same thing happened last year in a different place in her landscape. She also points out that this problem's occurring in the lowest spot of her yard. Last year, she pruned all the dead growth as the prairie verbena was dying, and that plant's barely come back this year. I can see why this would be perplexing. And it's the perfect opportunity to point out some of the issues about our local climate that we have to understand if we want to be successful with drought-tolerant, low-water-use plants, like the beautiful prairie verbena. Not surprisingly, your situation seems to have occurred right about the time when we received several inches of rainfall in one rain event. And you note that you have mostly clay soil and the plants are in the lowest spot of your yard. The low spot of a clay soil yard is going to stay too wet for many low water plants if we get a significant amount of rain. The good news is that you can still have this beautiful plant in your yard with just a few adjustments. First, avoid placing low water use plants in low spots in your yard, but if you do, you can build berms to raise them up. Be sure to use loose, well-draining, non-clay soil so that the plant's roots don't stay too wet. Also avoid mixing with organic matter. Soils that hold nutrients, even in small amounts, are problematic for plants that prefer a dry, loose planting area. The plant doesn't use the nutrients, so they serve as a food source for microbes. Combine this with wet soil and you have a problem. Too much water, which rots the roots, and plenty of food for potential pathogens. So ultimately, your prairie verbena likely succumbed to some sort of crown rot or other disease. This happens almost every year in our demonstration garden with wine cups. Like you, we preen it back to the crown and hope that it comes back next year, which it usually does. If yours doesn't, consider replanting in another location, perhaps with berms. Our plant this week is Mexican bush sage, Salvia leucantha. Like virtually all plants in the Salvia genus, Mexican bush sage does extremely well in Central Texas garden. As its name indicates, it does get rather bushy, so give it plenty of space, at least 3 feet or 4 if you have it. This gorgeous plant will be covered in bright purple blooms from summer through fall, and its gray-green leaves make a nice contrast. This color combination is common in desert-type low-water-use plants, which are very popular. Because it gets so large, one plant is plenty for most landscape beds, so resist the urge to overplant when you first install it. Salvia leucantha is reliably perennial in our climate, so be prepared to shear it to the ground in winter for a rejuvenating effect next spring. Our viewer pick this week is from Bonnie Woods, who found this ladybug next to its pupa case. She found 8 pupa this past week, and 4 have emerged over the course of the day on her watermelon vines. That's so neat. Thanks, Bonnie. We'd love to hear from you, so please visit us at klru.org/ctg to send us your questions and pictures from your garden.